Hello, welcome to Engineer's Mindset. Now let's say we have the problem f of xy equals, we have x sine y multiplying y squared cos x squared multiplying log x y squared. Okay, so we have about three functions here multiplying each other. Okay, so as usual, I will simply say, let u be simply equal to x sine y. Okay, let v be equal to simply y squared cos x squared. So I have y squared cos x squared. And finally, let w be simply equal to, so I simply have log x y squared. So log x y squared. So we simply have this, okay? So this now implies that f of x itself, f of xy is now equal to, so in place of x and y, I simply call that, in place of x and y, I simply call that u. So I have u multiplying by, in place of y squared cos x squared, I simply call that v multiplying by, in place of log xy squared, I simply call that w. So we simply have that f of x, y is simply u multiplying v multiplying w. So this actually was a triple product. So we're going to apply the product rule, but in this sense now, it's going to be what? A triple product rule. Now, here is the product rule. Okay, so to find the partial derivative of f x, y, okay, with respect to x, this is simply, here is what I will do. I'll keep u v constant, differentiate w partially with respect to x. So I'll simply have u v partial w partial x plus, next I'll keep v w constant, differentiate u partially with respect to x. So I'll have v w, okay, partial u partial x plus, and finally I'll keep u w constant, differentiate v partially with respect to x. So I'll simply have u w partial v partial x. Okay, so this is how to apply the triple product rule. Okay, so when you have triple products, that's simply how to what? Apply the rule. So we know, as usual, we know u, we know v, we know v, we know w, we know u, we know w. All we need to do now is what? Find partial w partial x, also find partial u partial x, also find partial v partial x. That's all we need to do. So from u equal to x sine from u equal to x sine y, from u equals x sine y, okay, I want to find the partial derivative of u with respect to x. Okay, so from the principle, of course, is a product of two functions. So if you are following this series very well, everybody can differentiate this from product rule. So we are simply going to apply shortcut to differentiate this. Okay, all right, so partial u partial x is simply equal to, so from product rule, you keep this constant, differentiate this, plus keep this constant, differentiate this. So you simply say let u be x and let v be this. So from product rule, we keep x constant, that's like a shortcut, keep x constant, differentiate sine y with respect to x. But notice now that sine y is just what? Depending on y. It does not contain any variable as x. So which means if I want to differentiate sine y with respect to x, I'm going to treat it as a constant since it doesn't contain any value or variable of x. So therefore, the derivative of sine y with respect to x automatically becomes zero. So therefore, we simply have this to be simply what? Zero. So from the rule, keep x, differentiate this with respect to y. We've done that. Now, plus keep sine y. Okay. Okay, you now differentiate x with respect to what? X. And if I differentiate x, I will simply have 1. So you have this. So therefore, partial u partial x is simply equal to 0 times x here simply gives us 0. So I'm left is simply what? X. So I'm left is simply what? Sine y. So therefore, this is simply sine y. Okay. So partial u, partial x simply gives us sine y. Alright, so if you've obtained that value, we've obtained partial u, partial x. Okay, next thing is to obtain what? Partial v, partial x. So invoke from v equal to y squared cos x squared. Okay, from v equals y squared cos x squared. Same thing, let's now differentiate v with respect to x. So we still employ the product rule, because we have y squared multiplying by what? Cos x squared. So these are two functions multiplying each other. We still employ the product rule. And from product rule, we said simply keep y squared constant, keep the first variable constant, differentiate the next variable with respect to x. And to differentiate cos x squared, first of all, I said if you want to differentiate a trig function, you first of all differentiate the angle in front of it. Use that derivative to multiply the derivative of the trig function itself. So I have cos x squared. If I differentiate x squared, I will simply have 2x. So use that 2x now to multiply the derivative of what? Cos. If I differentiate cos, I will simply have minus sine. Okay. So this simply will give me, okay, times minus sine x squared. Okay. So that is that. So keep y squared, differentiate cos x squared, which I have done, plus. Now you keep cos x squared and then differentiate y squared with respect to x. Since I have here y squared, there's no x attached to it, therefore I will treat y squared as a constant, and if I differentiate y squared, it's simply going to give me what? Zero. So this is actually times zero. So that simply implies that partial v partial x is simply equal to, of course, cos x squared times zero automatically gives me zero. So I'm simply left is simply y squared times 2x, okay, times minus sine x squared, and this is simply minus 2x y squared sine x all squared. So this gives me partial derivative of v with respect to x. Next is to find the partial derivative of w with respect to x. Okay, so from w equal to, we simply said let w be log x y squared. Okay, from w equals log x y squared. So please look up my shortcut video on how to differentiate log functions. So I did a video on that. Okay, to differentiate log function by shortcut, here is what you do: partial w partial x, we simply differentiate w with respect to x. So I said in that video, to differentiate log functions from shortcuts, simply what? Differentiate the function in front of it. Use the derivative to multiply the reciprocal of what? The same derivative. So you differentiate this function first, then use its derivative to multiply the reciprocal of this same derivative in front of it. So the function is simply x y squared, and I want to differentiate x y squared with respect to what? X. So which means I'm considering y squared as constant. So that means all I'm differentiating now is simply what? X. So if I differentiate x, I will simply what? Have 1 times y squared, which gives me what? Y squared. So the derivative of x y squared with respect to x is simply what? Y squared. Use the derivative y squared to multiply what? The inverse of what? X y squared, which is simply x y squared. So notice here that y squared can strike y squared. This simply gives me 1 all over what? X. So the partial derivative of w with respect to x is simply 1 all over x.
Alright, so we already know, so we already got the value of partial v partial x to the base. We also obtain partial v partial x to the base, and we also obtain partial w partial x to simply the base. So all we need to do now is to simply what? Plug into the what? Product what? Equal to the function. Okay, so let's try it and see now. Alright, so partial f. Partial x is now equal to, so the loss in this is hold u constant, hold v constant, then multiply by the derivative of w with respect to x. So we said u should be what? X sine y, and v is simply y squared cos x squared. So we keep them aside, x, okay, u is simply x sine y, okay, multiplied by b, this is the y squared cos x squared. Okay, so all this can be multiplied by partial derivative of w with respect to x. And partial derivative of w with respect to x simply equals 1 all over, simply equals 1 all over x. Okay, so simply multiply it by 1 all over x. Okay, plus next now we simply was both e, both w, find the derivative of u with respect to x. So keep p and w constants. So d is still means y squared plus x squared. W is simply log x y squared. So keep p, okay, plus d now is y squared plus x squared. Keep p, keep w. W is simply log x y squared. So now log x y squared to multiply by the derivative of our u with respect to x, and partial u partial x simply gives us sine 1, so multiply by sine 1, okay? Alright, so plus. So finally, you keep u, you keep w, then differentiate p with respect to x. So u is simply x sine y, and x sine y. Keep u, keep w, w is simply log x y squared, log x y squared. Finally, differentiate p with respect to x, and we obtain partial derivative p with respect to x to simply this, which is minus 2xy squared sine x squared. So you simply have minus 2xy squared sine x squared. So we have this, okay? So simply look now to see if anything can actually add or subtract if we expand the brackets. Alright, so if we evaluate this, we simply have partial x is simply equal to. So remember here, the root of the variable is multiplying 1 over x. So we simply have then x sine y multiplied by y squared plus x squared. So nothing gives us x y squared sine y cos x squared all over x. Although the root of this variable is multiplying 1 over x. So we have this. Plus, okay, here we have y squared plus x squared multiplying with x y squared multiplying sine y. So this is simply was y squared, okay, log x y squared, log x y squared, okay, plus x squared sine y. One, so we simply have this, okay, and finally plus, okay, so here we have x sine y multiplying by log x y squared multiplying by minus 2x y squared. So here x multiplied by this exponent of x squared, this now we have plus minus sine, so minus sine is not plus, so minus multiplying this plus minus, so simply have minus, okay, so 2x y squared multiplied by x as b is 2x squared y squared, okay, you can bring down the x y squared, your x y squared, okay, and then sine y and simply sine x squared. So we have this. So notice here that of course x can actually strike this x and this is ours. Okay. Alright, so also notice that sine y is common amongst all, that sine some y here, I have some y here, I also have some y here. Also, we see that y squared is common to the control. I have y squared here, I have y squared here, I also have y squared here, so it means y squared is common. So I can actually fill out y squared sine y. So let's do that now. So partial derivative, the function f with respect to x is now equal to, so simply y squared sine y is a common. So we have it. So from here, we have that x cancels x. So what I have left here is simply 1 cos x squared. So put down cos x squared. Okay. Meanwhile, here, what I have left is simply log x y squared cos squared x. Okay. So I factor sine y. So I simply left with log x y squared cos x squared. Okay. So I simply have logs. X y squared cos x squared. Okay. Also, so here I simply have a factor of y squared, a positive factor of sine y, and then simply minus 2x squared cos x squared. Okay, minus 2x squared log x y squared sine x squared. Okay, that's simple. Minus 2x squared, anything down there. Minus 2x squared log x y squared sine x squared. So this becomes the answer to that partial derivative with respect to x. Okay, so you can as well want to try to solve the partial derivative of that function with respect to y. Because this change, the only thing is that now the formula is going to be a little bit different. See, so differentiating with respect to y, but this is the same thing. So for a triple product, we simply have up partial w partial y plus v of the partial v partial y plus v of the partial w partial y. That's just it. So I hope you find it very interesting. Please, if you do, share your thoughts in the comment section. And of course, I will respond to all your questions. If you have any problem at all trying to solve the partial x partial y, don't forget to hit me up on WhatsApp. I will also come back. Please leave the WhatsApp and of course I promise to give you feedback as to the other videos. Thank you guys, I'll see you in the next video with more questions.